An artist, renowned for his genius.
You have the reputation of mocking the men of cloth in your work.
Do I?
Are you aware of how many powerful enemies you have? Well, yeah.
Fortunately, I also have a few very powerful friends.
A woman adored for her beauty.
Why doesn't that painting have a face?
Because he's a ghost.
No, he is not.
How do you know?
If you could tell me, growing up, maybe what your first impression of Goya's works were, what they meant to you.
I studied painting, and I have a whole, I think it was a good 3 months of working on the dark paintings of Goya. When the movie came, I thought, well, that's kind of a gift, no? That's a kind of a reward, because I had such a horrible time trying to imitate Goya.
When I was a student, I read a book about Spanish Inquisition, and that fascinated me, because it paralleled everything that was happening in the communist Czechoslovakia, or before and under the Nazi Germany, you know? So that was fascinating for me. Then many years later, I go to Prado to see Hieronymus Bosch. That's my favorite painter, you know? And there I see suddenly Goya illustrated the book I read 30 years ago. Here I see everything what that book was about, the auto da fés, the executions, the trials of Inquisition, you know, I couldn't believe that.
Beyond the canvas.
My daughter Ines has been summoned by the Holy Office.
Ines, that's preposterous.
Is a world where the powerful are declared righteous.
We have to return to the God-fearing ways of the past.
In restaging, putting life back into this Inquisition period, what was maybe the most shocking to be around just for yourself?
They recreated for me, for the film, all the instruments of torture. They built the, you know, torture chambers. They built the dungeons, the, you know, the interrogating rooms. And you see it in reality. My God, you get the goosebumps.
You have something to confess to it now.
But what do you want me to confess?
The truth.
But I did. Tell me what the truth is.
Natalie Portman, her character Inez, she has so much commitment to it, and you guys play such a edgy, mm-hmm. have such an edgy relationship. Do you talk about working with her?
She's a very beautiful woman, that's obvious, but also an amazing actress, being that young and so prepared, so deep. Like, when she works, she's so focused and she's so able to really go to every kind of place, emotional place, but it's quite scary to see it.
If this we were able to shed light on something that we keep doing as humans again and again, what would you hope that this film could perhaps shed light on it?
To put us at ease a little bit more with our faults. Because after every, you know, disaster, war, or whatever, we think, oh yeah, now we learned the lesson, never again. And of course, it happens again and again. Let's get used to it.
Why is she so important to you? You are completely obsessed with her.
That face is engraved on my mind.
I'm not going to abandon her again.